Tonight's game between the Northern Iowa Panthers and the Evansville Purple Aces. And, of course, we look here at our Star Watch. And, of course, here's our starting lineup.
I tell you, Brad Nessler, check out the matchup at center. These young men are really fun to watch and can definitely put up some big numbers. Definitely a matchup we should keep an eye on.
The teams are ready to go, and we're ready for the tip. And after all the anticipation, we're underway. Number 10 receives the ball. On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. He goes up with it.
That's a good post play because the footwork was excellent. So many guys walk with their pivot foot. He does a great job showing ball fake, and good footwork keeping his pivot foot down.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Both teams looking to get things going here. Inside, he takes the shot off the baseline. Perfectly executed. Morgan handles the pass. On the dribble, gives it up. From the corner, can't connect. Number 11 takes the feed. Might be a ball screen here, Dick.
Well, you got to use that screen. Hey, how to dribble use the screen is important in a pick and roll situation.
Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nessler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
He goes to the free throw line. He buries it. Got them both.
He converts on that free throw line, and that's major.
Number 10 receives the pass. He tries the jumper. Scorches the net with a J. He strokes it. Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going. Top of the key. They work the perimeter. He attempts the jump shot. Off the mark. Number 4 receives the ball.
Look at that spacing.
He tries to knock down the 3. They got it.
Freshman's a bit careless with the ball.
They'll work it around the arc. Number 55 with the foul. First personal foul. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket. You know, with him in the lineup, they've got one of the toughest things to get in sports, experience. But remember, Brad, experience doesn't always come from being on the court. It comes in many different ways.
And he got them both. Throws it up from downtown.
Excellent jump shot right there.
The shooting guard gets the pass. From three-point territory. I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
Brad, he's not getting any help out there. It's basically one against five. Not good odds.
Launches the three.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Moving it around the perimeter. In the lane. Carlson drains the jumper. This guy can really score in a variety of ways down on the low block, Dick.
This guy's the total package. He can beat you in more ways than one, and that's scary for any defense.
For the bucket. Shot off. Number four takes the feed. He makes the block. The Purple Aces pushing the ball in transition. Tries for two.
Terrific score off the fast break.
Gave it up. For two. That's good. Great job of occupying the high post, which ultimately leads to a scoring opportunity.
Certain offenses require that the ball goes through the high post. This will usually open up things on the wings and a low block, Brad. They did a great job of using the high post on that play.
On the outside. Puts up the J. Off the mark. On the dribble, gives it up. He goes for three. He has taken his team completely out of this game.
These young guys have to remember to let the game come to you. Don't force the action.
Morgan handles the pass. He shoots from the corner. Nope. They work it around the perimeter. Looking for the pick now.
Hey, a two-man game is great to watch when you have an intelligent dribbler and a skilled big man.
They move it into the front court.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing. High post screen.
Jumper won't go. On the left side, down inside, goes up for two. He hits it.
Tempo of the game really important here. You want to establish some good tempo.
For the bucket, makes the shot. A nice job of getting to the hole right there, Dick.
He has all kinds of moves, and we saw just about all of them on that drive. A good-looking 2 points.
Looking for a good shot. Tries for two. No good. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper. Missed it. Inside. From the corner. Doesn't go. Dumps it in. Let's watch the move as he works his man on a fadeaway jumper. He's taking a lot of bad shots out there, Dick.
I know, he's trying to catch fire, Brad, but it's just not there.
Takes his jumper and scoring. going to move it around the perimeter. He attempts the three. Gets the J to fall. Out on the wing. Lobs it. He gets the rejection. Brown's modest performance is bringing down his confidence level.
Well, he knows he's not getting it done, and emotionally, it's bringing him down.
Great pressure, great double team, really explosive.
Number 11 takes the pass. About 10 seconds left on the shot clock.
There's the screen up on top.
For two.
Man, he ran his man right into the screen to get off that nice jumper.
Goes up for two. The missed shot. Pushes it up. The Panthers are on the run. Gave it up. Fast break opportunity here. For the bucket. It's good.
Inside.
And it's heading out of bounds. No, great save. Tries for two. Now they work it around the perimeter. He tries the three. He misses the J. The point guard takes the feed. He puts up the J. Scorches the net with a J. They work it around the perimeter. Carlson picks up the foul. First personal foul. Well, it commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy baskets.
And here's a look at the first-year player.
You know, playing at this level can be a tough adjustment for some kids. Others make the jump look easy. It all depends on what kind of team you have around you and how hard you are willing to work to get better.
Number 10 is whistled for the foul. First personal foul. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits a foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
He goes to the line for the first time. Cashed it in. They have found their stroke at the stripe tonight, Dick.
This has always been an excellent free throw shooting bunch.
Shot, no good. Number 10 takes the feed. Looking for a good shot. From way outside. They get it to go. Controlling the ball. On the right side. Takes the jumper.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
For two. Makes it. He launches a three. Missed the jumper. He shows the sweet touch. Around 8 minutes remaining on the game clock. goes up for two. Comes up short. The small forward gets the pass.
Great effort defensively. He says, thou shalt not enter thy lane, baby. Get it out of here. I'm the landlord.
Let's take a look at this young guy's great performance tonight, Vic.
It seems like he's everywhere at once. He's been making good decisions and been strong with the ball. The coach has got to be happy with his performance so far.
The offense begins off the sideline inbounds. Backcourt violation.
Carelessness with the ball is never a good thing.
The Panthers here running their zone offense.
Well, the key to zone motion offense is you got to get good ball movement. If you get good ball movement to get the zone to really slide and use the skip pass to make it tough for that zone to adjust.
On the wing, fadeaway. He misses the fadeaway. About 7 minutes remaining. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Goes up. They got it. So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior. Shot usually creates momentum and opportunity.
Loose ball saves it. Great play. You always want your players going hard to the basket like that, right, Dick?
I tell you, he was fearless right there. Did a great job taking it to the rack and some great concentration to finish strong.
Scorches the net. We're at the 6 minute mark. And a momentary look from 3 point land. Jumper, nope. Brown receives the pass. Working it around the perimeter. For the bucket. Off the glass and no good. Number 33 takes the feed. The three ball nails the J. On the outside. Tries for two. Nice shot. We're at the 5 minute mark. For two. He can't get the bucket to fall. Number 12 is charged with the foul. Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nessler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
The Panthers are a pretty good free throw shooting team, Dick.
Hey, that means that they're doing a good job of practicing free throws.
Gets two at the charity strike. Carlson comes back into the game.
I tell you, they need their leadership out there. This kid's got leadership skills just like you, Mr. Nessler.
Strip, quick hand. The Panthers with the push. Too physical. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
The Panthers are a pretty good free throw shooting team, Dick.
Well, you know, when a team shoots a high percentage from the foul line, it means that they realize the importance of free throws.
Got them both.
Oh, he drained it. Nothing but nylon, NBN.
Number 5, coming in for the first time tonight.
He will give this defense a different kind of threat at this position. Smart move.
On the left side. Goes up for 2. Sinks the shot. What a pass on the backdoor cut.
That was a great cut and feed, Brad. A perfectly timed read.
Number 25 handles the pass. Now trying to feed and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
About 4 minutes remaining on the game clock. Knocked it down. Goes up with it. Knocks it down. Trying to feed the low block. He blocks the shot. The Purple Aces can't afford to have him pick up too many more fouls. Well, it commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket.
Number 25 goes to the line for the first time. Makes the first.
Those free throws count. Let's go back on that campus. It's BMOC. Big man on campus, baby.
On the dribble, gives it up. Puts up the jumper. Gets the J to fall. Three minutes left on the game clock.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set.
Gets the rejection. Gave it up. With the J. Gotta control yourself. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits the foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
When he gets to the line, he's usually making them.
Mentally, he truly believes that he can knock it down. It's a trait that many good free throw shooters have.
Makes the second. Dick, they're really getting it done from the line tonight, aren't they?
And a surprisingly collective effort, Brad.
Jumper. Nails a sweet jumper. They work the perimeter. They had a shot block. On the dribble, gives it up. With a fadeaway jumper. Look at that follow through.
I tell you, he's got every move in the book. What an offensive player. That fadeaway is impossible to block.
On the left side. 2 minutes left on the game clock. They go into the low block with a jumper and score it. There's a high screen. For the bucket. He gets it to go. handles the feed, sinks it.
Look at that spacing.
Tries for two, knocks it down. They'll work it around the arc. Takes his jumper. Jumper won't go. The point guard gets the pass. Moving it around the perimeter. He puts up the three ball. Nails the jumper. They look to get it to the inside. For two. He drains the bucket. Shot clock is dead. Number 11 is called for the foul. First personal foul. Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nesler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
With the pair. Gets the first shot. Some trouble here, Dick.
Great trap, Brad.
He fouled him. When he gets to the line, he's usually making them.
Mentally, he truly believes that he can knock it down. It's a trait that many good free throw shooters have.
Second shot is good. That line is really being good to him tonight, Dick.
That line's always good, Brad. These guys just have to make good use of it.
At the half. The Purple Aces are trailing by two. Evansville is losing in the battle on the boards in the first half, Dick.
Yeah, the opposing team was clearly more committed to rebounding the rock.
When we get going here today, these will be some of the keys that each team will be paying special attention to all day long.
We've seen a lot of action and some impressive play here today. A look at these numbers can give you an idea of who's been doing what.
Carlson comes back in.
You know, let's hope he didn't get too ice cold out there sitting on that pine. Sometimes you get to be a little frigid.
On the outside. There's a double team waiting there. Fed the low block. Uncharacteristic mistake by the senior. Pushes it up. Goes up. Can't connect. And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
Well, you know, the key, as you said, Brad, is motion. You have to have good movement on the perimeter to set up the guy on the inside. And everything's keyed about the entry to the post player. When he gets the ball, you can run backdoor cuts. You can run screens. You can run back screens. You can do a lot of things on the perimeter, get open layups off the key, getting the ball to the big guy on the interior.
He'll go to the line. Hits that one. They're shooting extremely well from the stripe tonight, Dick.
Yeah, they're making their coaches look good for making them shoot extra free throws every day.
Got them both.
He converts on that free throw line, and that's major.
gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebounding ability. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Goes up for two. Goes in. Looking for a good shot. He looks for three. Scores it.
He's just not giving the effort on defense.
He's not putting up a good fight at all. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Off the mark. That one's blocked from behind.
Great rotation by the D. I love it.
We're going to move it around the perimeter. Loose ball and batted in. Did the guy in the stands call for it? Let's check out this jumper one more time. He shoots from downtown. What do you think, Dick?
They need a timeout here, Brad.
Number 31 receives the pass. Now they work it around the perimeter. He rejects it. Number 11 takes the feed. Perimeter.
Unusual mistake there by the senior.
Out on the wing. Gave it up. Definitely a foul. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled him to prevent the easy basket.
Dick, we all know how important it is to get to the free throw line.
Well, there's no doubt about it. I think it's such an unbelievable plus. It means you're playing aggressive basketball, you're playing attacking basketball, and you're creating all kinds of foul problems for the opponent.
No problem so far at the free throw line tonight, Dick.
Well, they're making the most of the free ones.
They've got him trapped. The shooting guard with the ball. For the bucket, he drains the shot. And we're back. Dick Vitale and Brad Nessler with you here, ready for the inbound after that timeout. Takes the jumper. Nope. They wanted an offensive interference call and don't get it. Outside jumper. The missed shot. Tries for two. That was nice. Pack it inside for two. Off the glass and no good. Well, whose team tempo went out? That's a question right here, Dick.
You know, Brad, tempo is always important. Every team has their philosophy, and it's up to the players to follow the game plan.
Looking for a good shot. Looks at a three. Gets the J to fall. He unloads a three. Busts the jumper. Works the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Goes up for two. Off the glass and no good. The shooting guard handles the feed. On the dribble, gives it up. Top of the circle. He misses the fadeaway. And a momentary look from three-point land. Gets the rejection. On the right side. Working it around the perimeter. Puts it on the floor and up and under.
I tell you, good post play because the footwork was excellent. So many guys walk with their pivot foot. He does a great job showing ball fake, and good footwork keeping his pivot foot down.
On the outside. And we'll head back down to the other end. The Panthers have been making it happen with a number of different players, Dick.
It's been great to watch them move the ball like that, and they're doing all the things it takes to win. They're committed to playing good team defense, and when your team is doing those type of things, you're smiling as a coach.
For the bucket, goes. Unloads a three. Off the mark. Tries for two. It's no good.
Hey, Brad, this youngster is showing how to put the clamp on a player defensively.
Spectacular defensive effort. On the left side. For two, you betcha. A great backdoor pass right there, Dick.
You know, Brad, as a coach, you teach your players to read the defender. And when he's not looking, deliver the pass.
They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. Missed it. And we're going the other way. Boy, assist to turnover ratios are big, and that's a big turnover.
I'll tell you, they're turning the ball over too often. You can't win when you do that.
Trying to feed inside. Goes up for two. Can't put it down. I think they're trying to make a mistake. He cashed in on the layup and gets the foul.
He knew he was going to get fouled, Brad, but he took the hit like a man.
The The Purple Aces are a pretty good free throw shooting team, Dick.
You know, when everyone on the floor can convert from the line, it makes the team very tough, especially down the stretch when the opposition is trying to foul.
As the chance persists.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
For the bucket. Drains the shot. On the low block with a fadeaway jumper. Look at that follow through.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly. Uncharacteristic mistake by the senior.
Gave it up. Tries for two. He nails the bucket. A great backdoor pass right there, Dick.
There's nothing like a well-timed backdoor cut and pass. I'm sure they practice that all the time.
Morgan receives the pass.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. He shoots from the deep pit. The trifecta is good and the foul.
Big time shot here, Brad. Big time shot.
Well, he commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy baskets.
With the free one. He got it. They're making good use of their free throw opportunities tonight.
Good free throw shooting teams seem to always give themselves a chance to win.
On the left side, he shoots from the corner. They get it to go. The Panthers have a number of seniors in their lineup. That factor alone will definitely help their cause. Taken away. Turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
They work the perimeter. From the corner, nails a sweet jumper. Up with a shot. Off the mark. Turnover committed by the senior. The Purple Aces looking to attack in transition. Obvious foul. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits a foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
Steps to the line for the freebie. First shot is good. Dick, they're really getting it done from the line tonight, aren't they?
And a surprisingly collective effort, Brad.
They're seeing them all fall from the line tonight.
That's a crucial plus down the stretch, Brad.
A little two-man action. Here's a double team.
Look at that spacing.
Puts it on the floor and up and under. Jumper won't go. He gets it to fall. The freshman commits a turnover. Morgan receives the pass. He pulls up with a jumper. Nails the jumper. The Purple Aces are going to have to play some of their best ball to overcome this deficit. Luckily for them, they're an up-tempo team capable of scoring in waves, Dick.
Man, it's basically do or die. They play up-tempo so they could get back into this game. They need stops and quick scores, though.
Puts up the jumper. Nails the J. Left on the game clock. For two, he gets the shot to fall. Moving it around the perimeter. He goes up with it. Can't connect. The shooting guard takes the pass. The J. How about the shooting clinic from three-point land, Dick? It's been unbelievable.
Those guys have been on fire, Brad. Three after three after three. They're a confident bunch from long range, and the defense must change things up before this game gets out of hand.
Remaining.
Trying to go inside.
Now with about 10 seconds to shoot. Off the glass and no good. As we continue to track the game's tempo.
We've seen a combination of both short and long possessions here, Brad. Nothing wrong with that if that's your team's ideal style of play.
Dribble, gives it up.
Turnover by the senior.
The Purple Aces pushing the ball in transition. For two, with a layup. They work it around the perimeter. He takes the three. Missed it. 5 minutes left in the game clock. The shooting guard with the ball.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He unloads. He knocks down the jumper. Fadeaway jumper. He misses the J. Time to pick up the defense here now. The student section is all rallied up and they are ready to battle.
The student body looks like they're having some fun out there.
Looking for a good shot. He takes a three. Gets the J to fall. I isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper. He unloads a three, scorches the net with a J. The Purple Aces are definitely known for their frantic and up-tempo style of play, Dick.
Up-tempo teams really want to put pressure on a defense. They want to create tempo in the game, and they want the tempo to be at a high pace.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. His shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely.
Out of bounds, and we're not going anywhere. Ball's coming from the sideline. Zone offense now. About 3 minutes remaining. Ten on the shot clock.
Up and inside.
Goes up for two. Rims out. Rims out. He can't get the bucket to fall. Pushes it up. Remaining. So Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Gave it up. He tries the jumper. Nails the sweet jumper. Listen to the crowd. You can cut the intensity with a knife.
Wow, the energy is unbelievable in here.
He wants a three. Jumper won't go. The point guard receives the ball. Well, it's time to start fouling. They got to stop the clock, Dick.
Trying to execute on the inbounds.
1 minute left on the game clock. Foul, and that stops the clock again. They're set to throw it in from the side. And the clock stopped with a foul. They'll throw it in from the side. And they continue to foul to stop the clock. Again, they'll inbound on the baseline. Foul, man, that stops the clock again.
I like it when the team gets to the free throw line. It shows that they're being aggressive. The key is to get to the line early in the game and often.
Second one is no good. We'll get back to the action here after the timeout. Cross court. From the corner, he drains the jumper. Carlson handles the feed. Tough foul out.
Gonna be a long walk back to the bench, baby.
Let's take another look at this deep three. You know, when a team shoots this well from the line, playing aggressive defense can come back to haunt you.
I don't know exactly what it is, but these guys take great pride in their free throw shooting.
Gets his second. That line is really being good to him tonight, Dick.
That line's always good, Brad. These guys just have to make good use of it.
Looks like we're ready to step back out onto the court. Pushes it up. He shoots from the deep corner. In and out. Foul, man. That stops the clock again. With the freebie. Sinks it. They have found their stroke at the stripe tonight, Nick.
This has always been an excellent free throw shooting bunch.
Good. No problems so far at the free throw line tonight, Dick.
Well, they're making the most of the free ones.
On the dribble, gives it up. He shoots from outside. Whoa, not a good decision to take that shot.
That shot was definitely ill-advised.
They work it around the perimeter. Here they come with a double team to stop it. He misses the jumper. Howard receives the ball. Two with a lay-in. Evansville couldn't get enough going before the final buzzer.
I don't think anyone expected them to pull out a win tonight.
Brad Nessler saying so long for my partners, Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. Thanks for joining us.